Assalamu alaikum and welcome to this video. In this video, I will show you how to implement implicit intent in Android. So before implementing, first I will tell you what is the implicit intent. Implicit intent is used to move from one app to another app. This means if you want to move from one app to another app, you have to use the implicit intent. So for example, if this is a WhatsApp and this is a Facebook app, okay, if you want to move from WhatsApp to the Facebook app, you have to use the implicit intent, okay. And consider if the WhatsApp have two activities, this is the one activity and this is the second activity, and you want to move between these activities, okay, then you have to use the explicit intent. And I will provide the link of explicit intent in the description box. So before implementing this, I want to show you some other thing, which is this. So here is two methods. One method name is WhatsApp and the other is Facebook. And in this method, when someone clicks on the button, WhatsApp is open. Okay, this is the WhatsApp package name, con.whatsapp. This is the WhatsApp package name. Okay, and when someone clicks this button, Facebook is open and this is the Facebook package. So if you want to move the user to the WhatsApp or the Facebook, you have to use this package. Okay. Now I will show you how to implement the implicit intent. So first I am creating four buttons in the layout. So when I click Alt and Enter, it add permission to the manifest. Here is the call underscore permission. Okay, you have to write this permission for the call. So in this method we provide this number. Okay, so first of all the program asks for the permission of call. So if the call permission is provided, then this activity is start, and if the permission is not provided, then it returns. So we don't want to return. Okay, if permission is not provided, then we want to ask user to for the permission. Okay, so we write code here for asking permission. Okay, so in this way we can ask for permission from the user. Okay.